Hey guys, so it's been a while since I posted my last video where I gave you a simple trick to surprise the co-workers, mess their minds up. It wasn't too useful, but you know, it was a really fun thing to do indeed, of course. But this time I got something really, really cool for you, really amazing, something that you might as well end up doing all the time till the end of your lives. It's so good. So without further ado, let me bring to you Chrome hacks, because I mean, it's the only thing that we do right, browsing the internet. And what's better than making the only thing that we do even better? So let's do it. Alright, how many of you all have been in this kind of situation where you have so many tabs opened in a single window and it's so messed up? You lose all your motivation to work, just forget what you were looking for and go off to sleep. If you've been there and if you hate that, then this is what you need. Tab groups. And you see, I have grouped all the, you know, my work related tabs in the work tab group, the social media handles in the social tab group, my random pages I was browsing, the YouTube videos, Wikipedia pages in the random tab group, and so on and so forth. And to, you know, enable these, you need to know that Chrome already provides you a repository of experimental features which are not released yet, not deployed yet. And to access those features, all you need to do is type Chrome :// flags and press enter, and here you go. You see, it's a big ass list of experimental features which, you know, Chrome provides, and you can play around with those. And what we need is right now tab groups. So type something like tab, and you see the top choice is tab groups. All you have to do is change the label from default to enabled, and same for tab groups called labs, change it to enabled. And because if you do not do enable this one, you won't be able to collapse your tab group, which is a pretty neat feature, I guess. And once you enable these, you'll have a pop-up over here which will ask you to relaunch your browser to enable those. And once you relaunch the browser, it's done, simple as anything. And let's test it. Random website, I guess it's perfect. Okay, so all you need to do is right click on the tab, add tab to group, a new group, or maybe existing group, you know, whatever you need. And I'll go with a new group, and here you go, the group is created. To name the group, right click on the circle over here and name the group. I'll name it useless, and you can change the color as well, it's pretty cool, but I'll stick with green anyway. And that's it, that's done. So to add new tabs to the group, all you need to do is slide the tab into the group, and it's amazing, just done. And you see so many tabs, so many tabs in, you know, groups. It's pretty amazing. Anyway, you know, talking about it, you might have seen that, you know, whenever I hover my cursor over on a tab, there's a preview, right? And it's, you know, the second hack apparently. And it's really useful in case you have so many tabs open, you cannot read the title and you need to, you know, switch to tabs that you want to switch to, right? And let's say I want to switch to the Wikipedia page that I opened, but I can see three Wikipedia logos over here. I do not know, but you know, once I hover my cursor over the tab, there's a title and there's a preview, and that makes me realize, oh, this is the one that I need. And you know, it's a pretty cool feature. And to enable this one, again, you have to go to the flags and enable the tab hover cards feature and tab hover card images feature. And once you do that, the same relaunch story, and you get that. It's really cool, right? So I mean, in no time we are done with the second hack as well. Now moving on to the third hack, which is even more cool, you know, and that is, okay, so let's say you're watching a video on YouTube, and let's say for example this one itself, and you want to open the same URL on your phones or your tablets, or for example can be anything, you were browsing on Instagram on your laptops and you want come across a picture and you want to open the same picture on your phones, what would you do? Maybe copy the link to your WhatsApp web and send it over. And you know, can be many ways, but it's a pretty rough procedure, right? But what I got here for you guys, it's a one-click QR code generator. which simply takes in the URL from the website and generates a QR code out of it, and you can scan it on your phone and open the web page on your phone. Simple as anything. And it's really amazing. Comes in really handy to me, at least, because I keep on switching myself from my phone to my laptop to my phone again, and you know, it's amazing. And again, the same story, to get this, just go over to the Chrome flags page. I should have named this video flags instead of hacks, but who cares. Just type in QR, and there you see, enable sharing page via QR code, enable it, and the same story, relaunch your web browser, and then you are good to go. Just open your web browser and open Chrome to be precise, and once you click on the URL, you'll see this new button over here, new, you know, extension or whatever you call it, a tab over here, and you click on it, and that generates a QR code for the particular URL, and pretty neat, you know? Cool. So that takes us to the fourth hack. Okay, this one's for those of you who love to multitask around. Let's say you want to watch Netflix and do something productive along with that. Let's go for my favorite show, Naruto. Alright. Volume down for the time being. Right. And along with that, I want to do something useful, like make my office report or proof check my Medium article. Let's say I want to do that. And along with doing that, I want to watch Naruto on the same screen. What I'm going to do is pay close attention to this, because this is going to be really, really cool. Click here on this icon, right? Search for the video in the list of video that pops down, and which is, you know, just Netflix in my case. Click on the picture in picture icon over here, and you see the video screen shrinks down to, you know, a smaller screen on the tab you are on. Right, now this is so useful because I can do anything, right, and do anything on any tab and watch Naruto while doing that. I can switch over to some other tab and have the video playing here. I can scroll the video, I can change the position of the video, or I can even change the size of the screen, you know, according to how much I want to read. That was nasty, Sakura. Anyway, so this is cool because I use it all the time, and to do it, all you have to do is type in picture, and go for global media controls, picture in picture, enable it, and relaunch your browser, and you'll have it. All you'll have to do after that is play a video, search for this icon that appears when you play a video, click on it and choose the video, and you know, just go into picture in picture mode and multitask around. That takes us to the next flag, which is the dark mode. This one is for all those people who love the dark mode features on Facebook, Twitter, and any other website which provides a dark mode. And you'll be damned to know that you can force dark mode onto any website, and by any website I mean any website. And for that, you'll have to type in dark in the flag section and enable the force dark mode for web contents feature. And here you go, I'll enable it and show you how it is. Relaunch the browser, let's wait for it. And it's already pretty darker than before. It's kind of cool. I like this one, blue and dark. This combination is really good. Anyway, let's check some other websites out. Let's check out Google. Good. I would have liked it better if the links were in dark view like in the previous page, but you know, works good for me. Let's check out Medium, which doesn't really provide a dark mode as much as I know, and I'm not able to read the logo, but I guess it works for me. I guess I'm gonna keep this because it's pretty soft on my eyes. I like this one. Check LinkedIn out. I wish there was a switch for enabling dark mode or, you know, disabling it. That would have been better. LinkedIn is pretty neat, but you know, full of colors. I liked it blue better, but you know, since it's good on my eyes, I guess I'm gonna keep this one because, you know, color really doesn't matter, and after Social Dilemma, I don't really want to get addicted to the colors. Cool stuff. So it for the video. By the way, you know, since I showed you just 5 hacks that you can use, the 5 of which I use, you know, most often, I have many more flags that you can use to make your browsing experience convenient for, and those I mentioned in my Medium article, which is linked below in the description. Go check it out. Show some love if you like those. And talking about showing love, show some love to the video too. Like it, comment what you liked, and subscribe if you'd like to have more videos like these often. And goodbye till then. Bye bye.